So this is garlic right out of my fridge. Most people have it in their fridge. If it came from a drug company and it was hundreds of dollars for a 30-day supply and you own stock in that company, you'd be worth millions because it does so many things. But understand, drug companies want to study drugs that they can make money on. This is well researched though. There are studies. I'm going to look at one with you today. I'm going to tell you what it can do for your skin, why maybe you should consider taking it, exactly how to take it, and I'm also going to give you a recipe for a very easy mask, because if you're fighting acne, blemishes, garlic can help you quite a bit. As we're going to see, photoaging, the sun is one of the most common causes for people looking older, getting wrinkles, and getting skin cancer, but this can fight it. I'm also going to tell you exactly what type to take. One type is better than all of the rest. Most meals aren't complete with it, right? You're cooking with it likely every day, so you are taking it. Many people get their dose of garlic, but I'm going to take you through some studies and maybe it can help you increase your use or how you use it. Let's dive into a quick study and I'll show you all of these properties. Not just an antioxidant, not just an antibacterial, not just an antifungal, it also improves blood flow to the face. I'm going to show you that right now. You'll be amazed. So here's a study, garlic in dermatology, and it's a review. But look here, garlic is one of the best researched, like I said, best-selling herbal remedies, and it's commonly used for treating various health problems. I'm going to show you a few today. It's widely known for its biological properties and plays an important role as an antioxidant. So let's scroll down so we can look at exactly what are some of the things it can do. If we look through, I do want to talk about this right here, because this is applicable to you, which is the best form. So if you look, let's remove these markings. Four garlic preparations include, this is important to you because you might be using one of these four. There's raw garlic juice, there's heated garlic juice, because many people believe herbs, supplements, spices should be heated first. There's dehydrated garlic powder, we all know that one. And then there's aged garlic extract right here. And they call it AGE, unfortunately it's age, but aged garlic extract. These different types of garlic preparations have different pharmacological properties among the four preparations. It's important to know this because when we heat something, the proteins change, the glycation changes, the antioxidant properties change. So heating things, I know this because we heat blood products like plasma gel, like PRF gel, and it changes the proteins, the albumin in the blood, and gives it different properties when we inject it back. The same thing for what we cook with. Tomatoes are another example. Slightly heated tomatoes seem to have more antioxidant effect. But if you look here, age, so the aged garlic extract is the most useful, they note, of all of these. And the garlic extract is made from whole or sliced garlic cloves that are soaked in alcohol solution for different amounts of time. So I think this is reasonable to note, but I do still think cooking with fresh substances, heating them a little bit, offers a lot of benefits. But I think that's interesting for those of you who are taking aged, let me know who is. It's nice to know. So I wanted to come down and show you here, this is key, because when we look at studies of skincare, for instance, and we have people use a placebo or a dummy product, and then a product with an active, the people with the dummy product or the product that doesn't have anything really in it, sometimes get a 30 or 40% placebo effect versus, say, an active product like a retinol or whatever it might be that's well studied, hydroquinones. And that is because we think massaging the skin, no matter what you do, improves it. It improves circulation, collagen stimulation, and that's the exercise face exercise people would advocate this, and the people using the rollers and different devices. But look here, this is what garlic does. A randomized placebo-controlled double-blind study, that's what we want, that's the best kind of study, prospective, show that 5 hours after the administration of garlic powder, a significant increase in capillary skin perfusion occurs by 55% in healthy volunteers. That's a lot, by the way. The increased erythrocyte velocity, so that's how they measure. You take a vessel, you can look and you can see the erythrocytes because red blood cells are larger, larger than white blood cells and other cells in the body. So you can measure them with a Doppler, whatever you want. And they measure them, and the velocity increased from vasodilation of precapillary arterioles. This is important because the capillaries are the small vessels that will perfuse superficial skin and small organs. So this is exactly what's showing, which increases the diameter of them. This will likely lower the blood pressure too, because you're increasing blood flow to the periphery, not the central core of the body. The next thing to note here is the immunomodulatory effect, because we're talking a little bit about acne. I'm going to tell you about a mask. Also, taking it orally, the major immunomodulatory proteins have been identified, known as garlic lectins. So a lot of data research went in to figure this out, obviously. Aged garlic, so the AGE extract, has more potent immunomodulatory effects than raw. Garlic extract potentially induces the lymphocytes proliferation and macrophage phagocytosis. So white blood cells fight infection. They come and eat the bad things, the phagocytosis, like a little Pac-Man. And it stimulates infiltration of these macrophages and lymphocytes in transplanted tumors. Very important, because it has, as we see down here, anti-cancer benefits. Another well-studied faction of this product. So understand, it has antibacterial effects, antiviral effects, and cancer is like a runaway cell. They start dividing. So the immune system plays a key role in fighting these off. It's why I always talk about healthy lifestyle, healthy diet, healthy exercise, because that helps boost the immune system, carrying a healthy weight. The last one I want to show you today is important: UVB protection. B, think of B for bad. Those are the bad sun rays. Garlic stimulates the proliferation of macrophages and lymphocytes and protects against the suppression of immunity by ultraviolet radiation. What the sun does, it does many things, including increases pigment, melanin production, brown spots, sunspots, but it also decreases the immunity. It's why skin cancer is on the rise and one of the most common cancers in the world, especially lighter skin types. Aged garlic extract contains ingredients that protect from UVB-induced suppression, hypersensitivity. So understand that the sun damage caused by UVB rays does many, many things in the skin, and garlic seems to protect against it. Very important. And there's so much more for the skin. If people are interested, we can go through a different time, but psoriasis, alopecia areata, where you lose hair, keloid scars, important for those getting surgical procedures, because also talk about neem oil, better than many scar creams, plays a role in wound healing. On and on and on, what garlic does for the skin. And if you look through here, I mean, we can look here, cutaneous corn, fungal infections. I told you it was an antifungal. Anti-aging, let's look there for a minute. Let's take that, let's erase this. Come on down, anti-aging. According to an investigation, garlic shows beneficial effects on the maximum proliferative capacity of fibroblasts. Fibroblasts produce collagen. It's what we stimulate with platelet-rich fiber, with biostimulators, with Sculptra, with all the things we're injecting, devices, heating devices. So imagine if you're on garlic at the same time that you're getting these procedures to stimulate collagen. This all works together. It's why everything's a combination. It's also why patients have a responsibility after procedures, during procedures, and post-care to be on the right program or regimen, because it all works together to make the skin look beautiful. Now, let's go into a mask. I'm gonna give you a recipe for a very easy garlic mask. So for those that don't wanna get procedures or anything done, imagine if you're on garlic, you're maximizing your own collagen. For those that are getting procedures or injections, high frequency ultrasound, injectable biostimulators, whatever floats your boat, lasers, chemical peels, people are doing these at home. If you're optimizing your collagen producing mechanisms at the same time, it's going to make it work so much better. And for those that are getting expensive procedures, you're spending thousands of dollars. Patients have that responsibility to take care of their skin and take care of their post-care. But healthy diet, exercise, maintaining a good weight, being on the right program and by taking a few of these supplements that you're probably using in cooking in your daily life anyway, maximizing the collagen production and beautiful skin with all your adjunctive treatments. So don't discount the role of food. Now, what would be an easy do-it-yourself mask you can do? Whether you have acne or not, you can try this below. I did a turmeric video. I love that people commented how they take it. What are their programs at home? What are their shakes? What form do they take? That's what this channel is all about. A very simple mask that I use with my patients and get their feedback on. The first thing you do is you take 3 cloves of garlic and you mash them up. So you make a paste almost from that. Then you're going to add 2 tablespoons of white clay. And finally, you're going to add 3 tablespoons of honey. You mix that all together, and if that paste seems to be too thick, you add a little bit of water to thin it. You then apply that on the face. You can leave it for up to 15 to 20 minutes and then remove. People seem to love that simple recipe. And it helps glowing skin, it helps reduce acne. I'm sure there may be other benefits like antioxidant benefits. Those haven't been studied, I can't really say that. But what I do know is patients love that combination and give me a lot of feedback on it. There are many ways to use garlic, not only ingest it, but also in a mask. I'm sure you have many creative ways. I'm also interested how many of you use aged garlic powder, or fresh garlic. My guess is most of you are going to put garlic in food, lightly cook it. I still think that's one of the best ways. How do you use garlic? Do you want more videos on different aspects of garlic and other things you can do at home? I put a complete list up here of supplements, things like turmeric and the best vitamins for skin, and one down here on biostimulators to help keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.